The National Investigation Agency has denied the allegation of Special Public Prosecutor Rohini Salian in 2008 Malegaon Blast case that she was under pressure from NIA to go soft in the case. The agency also denied that it had issued inappropriate briefing by any of its officers to the Special Public Prosecutor for impeding prosecution work of NIA cases being handled by her. It clarified that the work of the Special Public Prosecutor starts only after filing of charge sheet in the trial court and the Malegaon Blast case is yet to reach that stage. Maharashtra Anti-Corruption Bureau sought an explanation from the Women and Child Development Department about the alleged awarding of contracts without inviting tenders a day after claims in this regard emerged against its minister Pankaja Mundhe. ACB sent a letter to the department after Mundhe is accused of corruption while awarding contracts for supply of hosts of items including books and snacks for Anganwadis and other institutions. A report will be submitted to Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis today. Private sector have given a thumbs up to the three urban missions launched by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Leading industry chambers and infra companies say the urban push will revolutionize cities and create lakhs of jobs. The Reserve Bank of India has extended the date to exchange pre-2005 banknotes till 31st of December. It had in December 2014 set the last date for public to exchange these notes as 30th June. RBI has urged people to deposit the old design notes in the bank accounts or exchange them at a bank branch. The Aam Aadmi Party government presented ₹41,129 crore budget with a major focus on education, health and transport sectors. Presenting the budget, Deputy Chief Minister Manish Sisodia said that his government will put major focus on reforming tax collection system and asserted that it will develop Delhi as a world-class skill centre and medical hub. City Court rejects bail plea of West Bengal Transport Minister Madan Mitra. He was arrested by CBI for complicity in Sharda Chitfund scam case. The death toll due to heavy rainfall in Gujarat has gone up to 70. Amreli district is the worst hit, with 27 deaths reported. National Disaster Response Force and Indian Air Force have been pressed into action for rescue and relief measures in Amreli district. Over 100 people have been airlifted in Amreli district, while 1,000 people have been evacuated in Surat due to floods and heavy rainfall. A flood alert was sounded in Kashmir as several parts of the valley were inundated due to overflowing of Jhelum River. Hundreds of people moved to safer places in south and central Kashmir after the flood and irrigation department issued the alert, asking people living near the riverbank to move to safer places. As fears mounted that the incessant rain could trigger landslips, the yatra to the Kedarnath shrine has been postponed till Saturday. On Thursday, the pilgrims on their way to Kedarnath were stopped after a bridge for motor vehicles at Sonprayag was damaged. A woman who survived a plane crash with her baby was rescued after 4 days lost in the jungle, Colombia's Air Force and rescuers said on Thursday. The woman, Maria Nelly Murillo, and her young son were aboard a small plane that crashed on Saturday in a remote area of the western Colombia shortly after taking off from Cubado. Myanmar's parliament voted against several constitutional amendments on Thursday, ensuring that the military's veto power remains intact and that the opposition leader Aung San Suu Kyi cannot become president in an election this year. The legislature ended a three-day debate on proposed changes to the 2008 constitution and gives the military an effective veto over constitutional amendments. Two more patients with Middle East Respiratory Syndrome virus have died, taking the death toll in South Korea to 31. The Health Ministry also reported one new MERS case, taking the total to 181 in an outbreak that is the largest outside Saudi Arabia. The new fatalities had pre-existing health problems, according to the Health Ministry. Most of the deaths have been elderly patients or those who had existing illness. India and Pakistan face off in the Pool A of the Hockey World League semis. India enjoys a good run with two wins as many as matches, while Pakistan have won one and lost to Australia. The top four sides from the 10-team tournament will proceed to Hockey World League finals to be played in November-December in India. The top three teams will qualify for the Rio Olympic. Former world champion Vishwanathan Anand placed second in the Norway Chess Championship after a draw in the final round against tournament winner Vaseline Topalov. Anand finished with 6 points out of a possible 9. Topalov had 6.5 points. Paulo Guerrero hat-trick led Peru to a 3-1 win against Bolivia on Thursday, securing a place in the semis of the Copa America. Peru faces host Chile on Monday in the semi-finals.